McClellan herself is still a teenager. She was unbeaten domestically last season and she'll be looking to do that again this year.
Sally McClellan may still be one of the babies of the Australian track and field team, but her experience and credentials belie her age. The 20-year-old went to the World Championship back in 2003 and since has been virtually unstoppable in the 100 metres sprint and hurdles, before getting a wake-up call last year when she faced Jamaican Bridget Hilton Foster. She's still learning her craft, but one thing she doesn't lack is drive.
I'm such a fierce competitor. I get out there and I think, as anyone would, I'm better than anyone else here and this is what I'm here to do. I deserve to be here. So just get out there and run as fast as you can and don't let anyone beat you.
An emotional roller coaster is how McClellan describes 2006. Falling in the Commonwealth Games final left the teenager inconsolable, and she eventually dealt with those demons with a psychologist.
I think I was too hyped up for that race and I was actually in trouble a few hurdles before I actually hit the ninth. And that's what a psychologist helps you with dealing with is during the race, how is your mind solely on yourself or is it, you know, on other people? And mine was on other people, not myself.
That's one barrier McClellan has overcome. Next is the Australian record for the 100 hurdles. It was set in 1972 by Pam Kilbourne, an Olympic silver and bronze medalist. And when McClellan broke 13 seconds at the World Cup last year, she became the first Australian to get close to breaking it.
You can't not make that a goal because I'm only 200ths away and I don't want to break it by 100ths. I want to break it by, like, you know, 0.2. That would be awesome.
Running a sub-13 second race was a huge breakthrough, particularly given a limited preparation for the race. And it wasn't what McClellan expected to see when she looked up at the time.
I looked up at the screen and I looked once and I looked away and I'm like, did I just see 12.9 against my name? And I wasn't sure because I think the Athens, the Greece flag was sort of covering the time up a bit and it was flapping across the screen and I looked up again, I'm like, oh my goodness, I can't believe it. This is so amazing and I was jumping up and down.
Having been to the World Champs as a 16-year-old, McClellan has big race experience to now draw on. But she also needs greater competition at home to push her to the next level.
It is kind of hard being so young and being the fastest in Australia because it just makes you think, oh, I hope someone's coming up to help me for future years because if the girls aren't running fast now, then what's going to happen in the future?
For some athletes, training can be a drain, but McClellan finishes a session wanting more. With a good 15 years left in the sport, coach Sharon Hannan has to limit her training to ensure she's right when she's at her peak.
That's right, I keep saying, oh, is that all I'm doing today at training? She's yes. I'm like, but I can do more than that. I can feel I can do more than that. She's no, you're stopping there. I'm like, oh.
So you're sort of, your biggest obstacle is you.
That's right.
Some dreams live on in time forever. Those dreams you want with all your heart. And I'll do whatever it takes. So I'll go the distance this time.
at the moment.